quite an interesting request for a video, and it was, could you tell us a bit about a day in the life of a pro writer? And I thought, yeah, I could do that. That's interesting. That's really, nobody's ever asked me about that before. So I thought, yeah, why don't we do that? And I thought, rather than just do a really tedious video, I'll do something during the video to make it less tedious, hopefully. And so I thought, I'll do a quick subway while I'm doing it. So let's get into it. So yeah, how do I go about my day as a let's call me a professional artist illustrator? That's how I relate to myself, really, because even though essentially I do a form of graffiti for a living, I draw characters and I draw names and stuff like that, I don't paint for a living. And I'm sort of, it's interesting, a lot of the guys I know who do paint for a living are often sort of trying to give up painting for a living. Because painting, particularly as you get older, people have probably said this to you already, you know, or those of you older, you know this already, which is, it's hard work. Really, really tough on the body. And yeah, it's it gets progressively tougher the older you get. And you think you're going to be the exception to the rule, and of course, you're not. So anyway, I'd sort of refer to myself as a sort of, I guess, a professional illustrator of graph, I guess. So anyway, that's the semantics out of the way. How do I start my day? Well, first of all, I've got to take the dog for a walk, because if I don't, he comes and sits next to me in the studio, eyeballs me the whole time, and will not go away until he's been satiated. So that's a thing. And once that is done, I can get back into the chair and I can think about the day's work. So first thing I do, because all professional artists will sell our services and our goods online, I have to check the online to see what sales have come in and do logistics around that. That's the first thing I have to do. I then have to do shipping labels and all that sort of stuff. Those of you who do mail order already, you know what all this is. You have to do shipping labels and you have to sometimes do mail runs or pickups and all that sort of stuff, that running mail order stuff. I don't like to complain about it because I'm very grateful for it. It's the kind of business that I was trying to set up 20 odd years ago, and I'm now lucky enough to have it up and running. So I'm most glad of it. So that's the first thing I do. Sometimes do the actual physical mail, which will mean, and it's really, really boring stuff. I won't get into too much of the boring stuff because, you know, all businesses have the boring stuff. I won't get into accountancy and all that sort of stuff. You can learn that anywhere. But I have to do things. I do have to go like the post office and make sure online accounts are all topped up with money so that when I do mail outs, often, you know, I forget, the post office phone me up and say, put some money in the account so we can send the stuff off, you know, all that kind of stuff. So all the sort of that sort of mail or logistics stuff, first thing. That's the first thing to do. Then I want to do things like, I want to check online on the socials. Not yet getting into doing social media, probably, because it's not a great thing to do in the mornings, social media. You know, avoid it till later on because you don't want to get sucked into that world too quick. So things like checking magazines and books, you know, to stay relevant. You've got any professional artist, this is the way. You know, if someone wants to kid on that this is not the way in graph, then they're living in the dark ages. You've got to keep up with keeping your name out there in media. That's how it all works. You know, there's a lot of people who say, I don't really do that, I don't really keep up. You know, well, if they don't, they lose their relevance very, very quickly. You've got to stay relevant in media. You've got to be in magazines, and you've got to be at a certain level, you know, not when you're a beginner, obviously, but a certain level, you've got to be in magazines, you've got to be watching out for books and stuff like that. Often you get invitations, people will invite you to go and be in a book or a magazine or something, and then it's all about the logistics of that. I mean, that sounds very simple, but I've been guilty of it myself. You know, I did 2 interviews, I think, last year that I never sent off because I never got even 12 pictures together out of a file, because it all takes time, and I didn't do it. And my apologies to those people who I was supposed to do them for. Just work takes over. That's what it is. But you've got to do it. You need to do it because it keeps you relevant. That's how it works. That's how media works. The old days of you know, getting up on a wall here and there and hoping that your name somehow gets out there. It's a global movement. It doesn't really work like that anymore. If you want to do walls and you want to get up that way and you want to get out there that way and you want fame that way, then you've got to do a lot of walls. You've really got to do a lot. But the thing is, you already know this, right? Because you know the people who are getting fame from doing walls, and you know who they are already. I'm talking like, you know, really like really super famous people. You know who they are, and you know how much they work. You know how many walls that... This takes ages to dry. You know how many walls they do, and you know how busy they are, and you know how much they travel, how many jams they do. You know, they do a lot. You've got to do a lot if you're going to do that. So you've got a bound to send. That's why you do it when you're young, by the way. Doing it when you're young is the best, because you've got all that energy to do all that. So I'll just wait for that to dry a little bit. So where are we? Yes, then you got to then I start emailing clients, letting them know about commissions, checking emails for commissions that are coming in, that kind of stuff. People wanting work done, wanting character work done, or wanting name work done, all that kind of stuff, and I'll price jobs up and send it off, all that kind of stuff. Now, bear in mind that I haven't even got round to doing any artwork yet at this point of the day, and that might take all day, that stuff I've just described. Emailing clients, checking publications for submissions, doing the mail, doing orders, walking the dog, trying to feed myself in the meantime, you know, that might take all day. The fact is that if you're a freelancer and you're a freelance artist, days don't mean very much, as in the working day doesn't mean very much. Be prepared to get up at whatever time you get up in the morning, 7, 8 o'clock, whatever it is, and work through till 10 or 11 o'clock that evening. The thing is, I don't want to sort of kid on that the work is like super hard, because this is the life we want, right? This is what we want. We work very hard at the art to get to a place where we are able to run an art business. I've just realised I'm going to have to do another coat on that, because that is ropey. I never do 2 coats on a map, because it's important that you can see the map underneath it, but this is totally different. I'm going to stick another coat on it. So yeah, no complaints. But expect to work a lot. You know, do the work. Because the work is going to take you a long time. If you get like big commissions, and you know, I've had canvas commissions, which they've taken me like 3 days. And if I work it out at an hourly rate, it comes in at quite a low hourly rate, but I don't mind, because this is the work that I want to do. That's why I'm very particular about taking commission work. A lot of people ask me for commissions, and a lot of people, I just say, you know, this is how much it's going to cost. You know, that breaks down to an hourly rate. It breaks down to a commercial license. It breaks down to how much I want to do it, which is a very big one. The older I get, particularly, it's like, well, do I really want to do that? Because if I don't, I'll probably charge it quite high. I've had that happen, by the way. Somebody came to me for a... What was it? A few years ago. Somebody came for me for an album. Was it an album cover? Single cover. Record, anyway, you know. And they said, yeah, I want a quote on this. And I was like, I'm not really feeling this one, to be honest. So I priced it quite high. And they said, yeah, that's fine. I was like, should have priced it higher. Don't really want to do it. But then once you're in, you're in. So you just get on with it. But anyway, at that point, after I've done all that stuff logistically in the morning, then in the afternoon, eventually I will start to do the work in hand. Like, for instance, this is the first piece of artwork and video I've managed to do all day. And it's now 10 to 5 UK standard time. Yeah, what do you call it? GMT, Greenwich Mean Time. 10 to 5. Most people are coming to the end of their working day. And I'm finally getting some non-logistical work done. So, and I'm doing artwork and making video and stuff like that. That falls into a particular segment of work because those two things go together. Yeah, obviously I'm making video right now of artwork. So that simplifies that a little bit. Later on, I will edit this video and I'll do social media and everything. I need to start another piece of artwork, ideally today, because I've got an idea. And that's a piece of artwork which is not a commission. That's something that I just want to do. I want to do it because artistically, it's a direction I want to go in. Which is another very important point. That light is in completely the wrong place. That's annoying. And now I've dazzled myself with it, so I can't. I've got a retina burn. That's even more annoying. So yeah, so I've got a piece of artwork that I really want to do, that I want to start later. Now, the fact is that I might, after doing this and editing the video and doing the social media and all that sort of stuff, I may not have it in me to do another piece today, which will be disappointing. But, you know, it is what it is. I'll have to hold it, I'll have to wait. Won't be the first time. So, after that, if there isn't after that, and often let me tell you there isn't, because that will take up nearly the whole day. If there's any time after that, then I can start to think about what how would I put it? Basically, sort of future planning, future proofing, that kind of stuff. About what I'm going to do going into the future. And that's things like trips planning. When I'm going to do another book. What I'm going to start doing. If I'm going to plan doing merch and that kind of stuff. What else? It's all things like books and magazines that that I would make myself rather than contributing to somebody else's stuff. And those plans are generally, there's stuff that kind of I think about when I'm doing artwork, but I can't really give too much thought to because I'm too busy trying to get lines to come out right, you know, and that kind of stuff. So like I say, merch as well is a really important one because merch is often how you tick over as an artist when you're not getting commissions, because sometimes it gets very, very dry. You know, you never know when you're going to get a commission. You never know when work's going to come in for you. Just talking about very dry. This is getting very dry. Come on, am I using an old one? Is this a new one? Am I using the wrong one? I think that's an old one. I can't tell you how many pens I've got. A lot. Yeah, that's juicier. There you go. That's better. I'm just going to blitz that, in fact. Let's blitz all that negative space in there. So that's probably that's my whole day. There's no room for anything else. Absolutely done after that. And I'll recap it for you very quickly. So, obviously walk the dog because, you know, he takes priority at the top. because if he doesn't, he'll just give me a hard time. After that, we're into checking the emails for orders. It's all about the online stuff, taking care of customers, because somebody who's been good enough to actually pay money up front for something, you know, you want to look after those people. Always, always very grateful to anybody who spends their hard-earned dough on my merch. So there's that. Getting off the post office. Make sure logistically the post office is done. All that, all the boring stuff, you know, all the stuff before it gets to the interesting bits. Emailing clients. Making sure, checking client queries that have come in, pricing things up, all that sort of stuff. Eventually getting to the good bit, which is actually doing the artwork. And then that, I mean, what I didn't mention before is, you know, I've gone to like the wee hours of the mornings. I'm sure a lot of people have gone to like, you know, I mean, in the old days, I used to stay up to like 4 a.m. doing artwork. I can't do that anymore because I'm too old to do that now. That gets very tiring. You will knock the stuffing out of yourself doing that kind of thing. And you can't sustain it when you're older. So I'd recommend against doing that. But yeah, make the video, edit the video. Very, very rarely do I not make video. I know recently I talked about it. I didn't make video for a couple of canvases, but that's just because I needed a bit of time and space just to do my own stuff. So mostly I'm making video, editing video, uploading video, getting social media, making sure social media is kept active, inquiries on social media, all that sort of stuff. And then future planning, future proofing, organising trips. You know, we're off to Southend this weekend to the jam. That's going to be a good one, I think. And yeah, book planning, magazines, all that sort of stuff. You know, trying to work out how that can be done. I mean, that in itself breaks down into a larger area, because that's all stuff like, do I have the current budget for it? If I don't have the current budget for it, how am I going to sort out the budget for that? Am I going to do a Kickstarter? Am I going to borrow the money? Am I going to do it? Am I going to look for sponsorship or advertising? Because that's a way of doing it. Or am I going to just sort of stick it on a credit card, or, you know, what? How am I going to do it? Working out the maths around. I won't go into all that stuff because that is boring. But yeah, that's pretty much a day in the life. So the artwork is the longest bit of it, basically, as in the bit that takes the longest. But like I said before, it might take me, well, what's it taking me today? I got up a bit late today because the hound decided at 5:30 this morning that she wanted to go out. So it all kind of went a bit wrong. So I didn't get up until 10 o'clock or whatever. And then after that, everything got knocked back a few hours, which means that it's, you know, it's now 5 o'clock in the afternoon and I'm just getting a piece of artwork done, which is very late even for me. And I'm not somebody, I mean, you know, all them influencers who talk about getting up at 5 a.m, forget it, man. It definitely ain't gonna happen. Not for me. That is not going to work. I've never been a morning person. Good luck to you if you are, but not for me. So that's it, really. That's the lot. And I thought this video might be useful because there probably are some of you out there who will want to turn pro one day. who want to start doing stuff for actual money, you know, making a living at it. I know there are, because people ask me. So, you know, there are certain things you can learn from anybody's business. You know, talk to plumbers about self-assessment and tax and, you know, all that sort of stuff. But you want to know what you should be doing, the specifics of the work, don't you? You know, what can I expect as a professional artist? I mean, what you really can expect as well is you can expect sometimes to go, like, you know, weeks go by and no commissions dropping in the box, and then suddenly a load dropping from nowhere, and then you're suddenly trying to manage your time. That you can absolutely expect. So that's about it, really, on the day in the life. I'm going to finish up this, and what I'll do is I'll put it into time lapse so you can enjoy the rest, speed it up, so you don't have to watch me laboriously go over this, because I've probably got another 20 minutes to do on this. So here we go. I'll speed it up.